Good morning, Haralson County Rebels. It's Wednesday, January 5th, and I'm Cole Warren with your morning announcements. But first, we're lucky enough to have Mr. Staples with us for a few friendly reminders.
Thank you, Cole. Good morning, everybody, ladies and lady rebels and rebels and stuff. I wanted to talk to you this morning. Actually, I was asked to talk to you on behalf of the administration, just to go over a few things that you probably went over yesterday, but I just want to make sure that we're all clear. Now, the first thing I want to talk about, and this is one that I don't really understand, but y'all shouldn't be getting to school before 7:40. Sleep in or go someplace else, but don't come to the campus until 7:40. When you get to the campus after 7:40, you've got to come in and go to your first block class. You can't walk around the school. This isn't a mall and you're not senior citizens. You can't come in here and walk around for exercise and stuff like that. Go to your first block. That will make things so much easier. Thank you. Also, don't be hanging out in the parking lot. That's just not a good look. If you're out there, there's no telling what's going on. So when you get here after 7:40, you park, you get out, you come in the building. Let's not make it weird. All right. Let's see. The next thing, food. We have free breakfast and free lunch. Everybody should go by and pick up a free breakfast every morning. Do not throw it in the trash. Do not throw it on the ground. Either give it to someone else or put it in one of the locations that we have around campus and someone else can have it. We're lucky enough to have the free breakfast and we're lucky enough to have the free lunch. If we don't take advantage of it, you're going to start paying for your food again. So get the breakfast. Let them think you're eating it. Don't just throw it away. That's irresponsible. All right, what else we got? And don't just not take a bag. Do the right thing with it. And at lunch, you're supposed to come straight to the cafeteria and eat. Don't stop by the restrooms and do the stuff that y'all are supposed to be doing in there, because y'all aren't supposed to be doing that stuff in there. Come to the lunchroom and eat. Stay in there the whole 25 minutes. If you want to come to the school store, that's fine, but go back down. If you're going to use the restrooms, I don't think they're backed up or torn up anymore, so you can go use the ones down there, but just one at a time, because when two people go in at the same time, that's not good. All right. Cell phones. I have a visual aid for this one. And the reason I want to talk to you about this is I'm sure your teachers have taught you about this ad nauseum. But here's what I want to make sure that everybody is aware of. If you use your cell phone in class, you're going to start off about right here with your first offense. You're going to get a warning and your teacher is going to contact the parent and it's going to go in infinite campus. That's not good, but it's a lot better than if you don't give up your phone. If you don't give up your phone, you're going to move down here to where you're going to be refusal to give up, defiance, and disrespect. Now, this first offense was a warning. This first offense, 2 days ISS. So there's a difference. So if you do have your phone and your teacher says, hey, Johnny, put your phone up. All right, because then you go from Johnny getting in trouble in infinite campus to Johnny getting disrespectful, 2 days ISS. All right, so we're good on the phone. Use them in the hall, use them in the bathroom, use them during lunch, but not during class. And also, if you're using your phone, don't take pictures and videos and put them on social media. Come on. Seriously, that stuff that happens in other schools, when you're trying to embarrass your classmates on social media with these photos and videos, you're not supposed to do that. That's not just against school policy. That's just ugly. That's not what we do here. So stop doing that. And if you go ahead and take pictures and videos and you put them on social media, I don't even know where on the rubric you would go. I'd have to imagine you're way down here. Like, you're going to get in some serious trouble, because that's not very nice. Oh, and the dress code. Just finally, just go by the dress code. Nobody likes a dress code. I don't like the dress code. I've got to wear pants every day. I don't like wearing pants. Mr. Coggins is a personal friend of mine. I had to get a note from my doctor just to wear tennis shoes because of my old man with a bad knee and bad feet. We have to go by the dress code. It's what happens when you go out in public. So just wear what you're supposed to wear. Wear it how you're supposed to wear it. Don't bring blankets. Don't wear your toboggans at the house. None of that stuff. All right, I want to get off to a good year or a good semester. We've only got about 5 months left. I think we can do it.
Right.
And I think that's everything. Don't make me come back and do this again.
Thank you, Mr. Staples. Any student who is interested in English 1102 on our campus in dual enrollment, please sign up with Ms. Brown today. In other news, there will be a track informational meeting Thursday, January 6th at 3:35 p.m. in the cafeteria for any student interested in track. Boys and girls soccer practice will be today after school on the practice field by the ROTC building. Congratulations to the HCHS Theater. Their production of The Figments has been selected to perform at the annual Georgia Thespian Conference in February. Only 24 schools from across the state were selected for this meeting of over 4,000 theater students. There will be two encore performances of Figments on January 25th and the 27th at 7:30 in the Fine Arts Building. Tickets are only $5 and are available on GoFam. Come be a part of the HCHS Theater Spring Musical Curtains. This exciting production is about a Broadway show that is experiencing a series of murders. It has several great parts for guys and girls. HCHS Theater is having an optional audition workshop next Wednesday, January 12th. The actual auditions will be the following Tuesday and Wednesday, January 18th and 19th. Students must be at both days to audition. If you are interested, see Mr. Steak, Ms. Bird, or Ms. Lugo for more information. There's also a Google Classroom where you can read the script, listen to the soundtrack, and get even more information about the auditions. Yearbooks are on sale through January 14th. You'll need to get one by then to guarantee you receive a yearbook for this school year. After January 14th, yearbooks will be limited supply and sold on a first-come, first-served basis. The prices will also increase to $80 on January 15th. Visit yearbookcenter.com with job number 2055 to order. Details in the video description below. See Ms. Blackman or a yearbook staff member if you have any questions. Attention all seniors. If you are interested in preparing for an upcoming job interview or would like to learn how to best be prepared for a future interview, please take notice of these dates and times for this workshop. These dates are also listed in the video description below. Please make sure to contact Ms. Schulenburg or sign up on Orion for upcoming communication alerts. The Color Guard, dance team, and majorettes are selling raffle tickets, $5 each or 5 for 20, for a large bog bag filled with beauty and boutique items and gift cards. The proceeds go to our uniforms for next year. Please see any team member for tickets. Thank you for supporting our team. Boys and girls tennis will begin this month. It's not too late to sign up. Any student interested in playing needs to see Coach Clayton in room 104. This applies to returning players as well as new players. That's all for the morning announcements. And remember, it's a great day to be a Haralson County Rebel.